Welcome to Belgrade, the city of rich basketball tradition and city of the Turkish Airlines EuroLeague Final Four Tournament 2018. My name is Vladimir Stanković, I'm 69 years old and I'm a journalist. And I will be some kind of your guide during this documentary on Belgrade's and Serbian basketball. We will try to explain why Serbian basketball was determinant in the last 30 years. Serbian basketball is always very present in Final Four tournaments. For example, in the last 28th edition, in 22 occasions, Serbian coaches or players has very, very important role of winning titles of his team.
Serbian nation is a very good soil for group sports.
Somebody said, yes, they are very, very specific, tall people. Somebody said, very big talents.
Nostro tiro, nostros jugadores y jóvenes y mayores tiran muy bien. ¿Por qué? Porque trabajan mucho tiro. Aquí hay una cosa, no puedes jugar bien baloncesto si no tienes tiro.
The talent is never enough, but definitely that in my country, the people is very, very hard workers.
My experience like coach that I really coach lot of great players is that they understand that individual work is more important than everything else. So this is, let's say, something that is a big tradition in Serbian basketball.
Many players are coming from the mountains and Serbia and Yugoslavia was formed by many mountains, and that's normal that the people coming from the mountains are strong and very hard and had the sense of the community. This sense of for me personally, of community is the maybe most important thing that we had have.
I ovdje su ljudi praktično naučili za sve da moraju da se bore. I to se i prenosilo i naravno na trening i.
I don't know, you know, I believe that everywhere in the world you have people that they have character, honestly. But I believe that Serbian players. From the very young, let's say, they start to have like dream to take the ball and to put the ball inside of the basket, the more important shot.
Ta ogromna posvećenost i ta ogromna tradicija koju smo mi imali u jugoslovenskoj košarci stvorile ovaj jedinstvenu filozofiju, metodiku treninga. Toga danas to je jedinstveno. Neko želi da kaže da ne postoji ta jugoslovenska škola košarke, ja kažem naravno da postoji, jer šta je škola? Škola je pre svega sistem, metodika treninga. Da li jugoslovenska košarka ima metodiku treninga posebnu? Da, ima. Da li jugoslovenska košarka ima poseban način selekcioniranja, odnosno izbora igrača? Da, ima. Posebno, različito od svih ostalih, ja bih rekao, i američkih i u ona vremena ruske škole, koške li je evropske.
Nostros jóvenes, niños pequeños, cuando no meten, cuando fallan último tiro, no pueden ir a dormir en su casa propia, porque padre está muy enfadado y toda la familia diciendo que vete en ballet, entrenar otra cosa, otro deporte, porque desde principio somos muy espartánicos, muy duros contra sus propios niños. Y poco a poco un niño crece con esta manera, meter último tiro.
We visit Mr. Borislav Stanković because he is most important person in history of Serbian basketball. He was first player after director in federation, he was coach. Coaching OKK Belgrade, And after he was the most important person in FIBA, International Basket Federation. He was general secretary more than 25 years. He's living legend of Serbian basketball.
We started to play basketball during the war time, because our club was the tennis club, and the courts were all tennis court. But it was good enough for basketball, and the idea to play basketball come from the people from this organization Sokol, from the professors of the physical education, and also some prisoners, Italian prisoners, brought the basketball a little bit in Belgrade. Later on, the basketball goes to the Kalemegdan, and the story started really on the courts of Red Star in the park of Kalemegdan.
At that court was playing the basketball Mr. Borislav Stanković, Mr. Radomir Šaper, Mr. Aleksandar Nikolić, and Mr. Nebojša Popović.
We always talk about four persons that they was crucial for the development of basketball in Serbia, generally in ex-Yugoslavia. This is Bora Stanković, Radomir Šaper, Nebojša Popović, and Aleksandar Nikolić.
Today, I will visit the grave of Professor Aleksandar Nikolić, who was a great expert and a long-standing Yugoslav national team coach, a winner of those earliest medals. He was the founder of the basic principles of the Serbian coaching school.
For me, the most important thing in this sense was the silver medal in the Olympic Games in Mexico City in 68. This generation was conducted by Korać, the famous scorer of that time. Even today, we were one of the best players ever we had.
His 99 points against Alvik, when he played for OKK Belgrade in Champion Cup, still very best individual record in this competition, what is today EuroLeague.
This generation, they brought the first medals, and this team also won the first medal on the European Championships here in Belgrade.
Ranko Žerovica deserves also our respect, because he was Yugoslav national coach many years, and with Žerovica, Yugoslavia won his first gold medal in World Championship played in Ljubljana 1970.
Quando il nostro baloncesto ha esplotato era Ljubljana. Campionato mondiale, Ranko Žerovica ganò medaglia d'oro. Desde entonces, este momento era momento muy importante, porque baloncesto è entrato in scuola.
Moramo da kažemo taj ogroman uspeh, pobeda, osvajanje prvenstva sveta u Beogradu, ne u Beogradu, u Ljubljani, dala zamajac i jednostavno i oni koji su do tada manje se bavili košarkom, više kao i uvek u Evropi fudbalom, jednostavno su videli, o, evo ga novi sport. Sećamo se da od tog trenutka na televiziji, jugoslovenskoj televiziji, prvi program svake subote imamo direktan prenos u 17 sati. To je za današnje uslove to je praktično ništa, ali u ona vremena to je bilo toliko značajno za nas, za košarku, za košarkaše, za popularnost i tako dalje.
Of course, like Serbian person, I'm very, very proud of this history that we have. I know that people like basketball. I know that kids over there like to work very hard, and I'm really very, very proud that my country have this kind of history talking about basketball.
I am Aleksandar Zmijanac, and I'm a director of youth categories at basketball club Red Star. You know, you probably heard before that many people said that Serbia is a basketball land. And for example, just in the capital city of Serbia, Belgrade, there are 90 basketball teams registered.
My name is Aleksandar Bučan. I am under 19 coach in basketball club Partizan. Then I am sure that we have a very successful future in basketball because when I looking all these kids, I'm sure that so many of these kids will become future big players from Serbia national team and also for all domestic clubs.
Dobro, ti? Odlično. Šta ima?
Ništa, evo navratio malo da vidim. Šta ima ovde na kališu?
A evo, nekrat. Šta kažeš na moju formu, a?
When I was shooting those shots, I just remember like the days I was practicing here when I was a little kid. It's so many history.
Yeah, also I remember always when I walking here around, you know, I came to this court and remember of my
there is some special,
childhood.
Special
yeah.
Feeling about this place.
Yeah, of course.
It's so much rivalry, and we share almost the same court. It's just a little bit between us. So much tradition in one place.
Yeah, so much tradition.
So much
tradition.
So many titles and great players.
And how many practices, you know?
Wow.
How many car practices is there?
Right, right. This is the land of basketball, right? Serbia. Everybody loves basketball. Everybody knows basketball. There is no secret in Serbian basketball. I think we just work a lot. We just practice a lot.
This winner mentality, you know, became stronger, you know, when after very good practices and big drills.
So, you know, some kids, they need to adjust to their pressure. They need to deal with their pressure, to fight with their pressure, you know, and we have to teach them that, right?
Yeah, of course, you know. But I think that this is also very good for these new kids, you know, because these kids learn from the best, you know.
And there is no just to participate. We have to win.
Yeah. Also, we know that in youth selection, you know, even if we not win, you know, we are in good way to win one day.
Exactly. Bučo, I know we are rivals, but I wish you so much luck in the future with you and your team, because this is all about basketball, right?
Yeah, of course. And I'm also very, very impressed, you know, with your quality. And because I know when we win against very good opponent and rival, you know, then we are good also.
Thank you very much.
I believe that any person who lives in Belgrade like to spend during the year some moments in Kalemegdan, this historic place, you know, with something that not so many cities have, that to watch two different rivers from the up and to see, let's say, all the part of New Belgrade over there.
Kalemegdan para mí es un símbolo de baloncesto. Seis años estuve trabajando yo en instalaciones, terrenos de Estrella Roja. Yo soy de Estrella Roja. Y justo al lado está terreno de cancha de Partizan de Belgrado.
Božidar Maljković is four-time European champion with three clubs, two times with Jugoplastika, one time with Limoges, and one time with Panathinaikos. He is now president of Serbian Olympic Committee, but he don't forget basketball and always can find time to speak with his old friends about basketball.
Nosotros hemos ganado, pero sin saber qué importancia tiene esta victoria y ser campeón de Europa. Y en avión volando, capitán, piloto ha pedido aeropuerto de Split qué tal las condiciones meteorológicas. Y gente respondió de abajo, ha dicho, hombre, como siempre, Split, siempre hay sol, pero no tenéis espacio para aterrizar. Hay 200,000 personas esperando equipo. En este momento, cuando desde avión Hemos visto gente abajo. Empezamos reflexionar, pensar qué hemos hecho. Me profesor Nikolić que llevaba un nitroglicerina en la mano porque tuvo problemas con corazón, quería hablar conmigo en solas, 3-4 minutos. Y bueno, cogemos un vestuario al lado, jugadores celebrando. Dice, ahora jefe, vas a seguir solo, vas a estar solo. En la vida, con años, no vas a tener muchos amigos. Solo familia es importante y unos pocos amigos. Si tienes 5 es suficiente. Y ahora conmigo, dentro, detrás de vosotros, están mis 5 de siempre.
Pričamo o Dimcu, o Paspalju, o Draženu, igračima koji su bili pioniri iz Evrope u NBA.
Nije NBA to što ljudi misle. U NBA-u imaš u svakom klubu imate 2-3 superstara, a ostalo su prosječni igrači. Ti prosječni igrači ne mogu da igraju u velikim evropskim klubovima tipa Reala, Barse, Panathinaikosa. Imao sam ih i znam da ne mogu.
Košarka je sport koji se razvija i ono je išlo kroz svoje faze. Da bi došlo u ovu fazu, NBA fazu. Mnogi igrači iz onih vremena, ne znam, neki Loci ili Gates, možda bi bili da danas igraju u NBA-u.
Je li Ivo Dane bio NBA igrač?
A kako da ne?
Svi kažu da je bio, da bi bio čudo u NBA-u. Da li je Praja, da li pak iće NBA igrač?
On je mogao, on je bio 15 dana u Bostonu i prošao je sve testove i ponudili su mu ugovor, ali on je bio malo... Izgubio bi pravo da igra za reprezentaciju, jer u to vreme nije bilo moguće.
Mogu da bude zvezda u NBA-u.
Tačno.
Ja mislim da je prelomno bilo Bormio i ona grupa ogromnih talenata koji su se pojavili u tom Bormiju, od Divca, Kukoća, Radže, da ne kažem Đorđevića. To je bila jedna generacija fenomenalna, odatle su polovina njih i otišlo u NBA. I to je počelo da bude jako interesantno. Evropa je postala da bude jako interesantna. Tako da, eto, ja sam imao sreću da treniram baš ove sve igrače od Saše Obradovića, koji nije bio NBA, Tomaševića i Paspalja Đorđevića, ovoga Divca, koji su, eto, korakom ogromnim krenuli u NBA. Mislim da je ovo podneblje dalo dosta igrača i evo i sada mi imamo jednu postavu koja je u... Ta postava je bila verovatno prvak Evrope bez problema. Vladane, pa NBA.
Teodosić Bogdanović,
Bjelica,
Jokić, Marijanović.
To bi bila verovatno šampionska bilo gde da se pojavi.
I have many friends in the Serbian Basketball Federation. One, of course, is Predrag Danilović, today president. But I remember him more for his great career. He was one of the most successful basketball players in our history. 4-time European champion with the national team, twice with his clubs. First with Partizan in Istanbul 92, where he was also MVP, and with Kinder in Barcelona 98.
How I remember 92 in Istanbul when we won, when Partizan won. That's probably one of the greatest memories to me while I was a basketball player.
Don't forget the Partizan, like the team which was Spanish without home court. He was playing in Fuenlabrada.
It's very difficult to find the words to thanks to them for everything that they're doing for us. I believe that they give us power to play any game over there, thinking that is our home court.
Duda Ivković is my very, very good friend, very close friend. And he talked to me, told me a couple of things. Look, nobody plays the final game to lose. Very simple. But you have to tell somebody the right time. You have to have great timing to say that.
And about Juventus, you know, I believe that everybody remembers how it was with shot of Saša Đorđević.
He was one kind of the player which controlled not only ball, 9 players, shot clock, and 2 baskets. He was always controlling 10,000 people.
And what Georgievi did changed our whole lives. And I believe we will always be great, grateful to him.
I believe that this final game changed destiny of a lot of us, honestly. But I'm very happy that this generation of the players that I coach in this moment, they grow up like players, but like also like persons. All of them, they are great people, and this feeling to meet again my players and all the members of my staff, even some people from the club, is something special, and always will be special. No, you know, I go to Juventus, and of course, all the people talking about this, that I need to give something back to them, thinking about this final that we play 2 years before. So, you know, during all the season, people talk like that. And we go to Final Four again in Tel Aviv. And finally, you know, we beat Olympiacos in final game, before in semifinal Barcelona. So after the game, I know that I joke with all the people. I say, now everything is fine. Now I don't need to give you anything back. This Final Four, it was in Saragossa. I remember very well that Sabonis played just 24 minutes, scoring 25 points. So he was, you know, really player in that moment, the best player in Europe, without any question, with Darlukas also. Because of that, we come into that to, you know, to take the trophy and to bring to Real Madrid after, I believe, 15 years, because last title it was 80, so after that, 95. Yes, my first year in Panathinaikos with, let's say, the players that it was my players in also in national team, Dejan Badiroga and Željko Rebrača, and all another very good players. Roster, it was really very good. Again, teamwork bring us to that to be European champion. Absolutely favorite in final game, it was Kinder Bologna, with Ettore Messina, with also Ginobili. And I remember that it was a crucial moment. It was that they lead in first half with 14 points. And I talked to team that we need to go in half time, you know, to don't be so big difference. And it was like that, you know, we coming back, and this way that we choose to play with four perimeter players give us a lot of opportunity offensively. We changed the game offensively, and we beat the team that it was really a big favorite in that final.
It's great pleasure to see again Svetislav Pešić on the bench of Barcelona. He is part of Serbian, but not just Serbian, history of basketball. He's only one coach who has won the European title with two different national teams, with Germany 93 and Yugoslavia 2001. He also won the world's title in 2002 and helped Barcelona to win their very first European title in 2003.
Uspomena na 2003. Duenja s Bodiroga, Jasikavicius.
Kad se govori o toj finalnoj utakmici ili Final Fouru ovde u Barceloni, onda se priča naravno najviše o Bodirogi, pa se onda priča o Fučki, pa se priča o Navaru, priča se o Pešiću, priča se o Šaranosu, naravno.
Mora da Bodiroga ne pogodi onu trojku.
Bam. Puno je on trojke. On je puno trojke pogodio. Kao i u svemu, moraš da imaš motivaciju za nešto da bi mogao drugo da motivišeš. Moja želja bila da dovedemo prvo Bodirogu. Bodiroga je igrao u Panathinaikosu i ja sam mislio da je on tamo svoj posao završio i da on traži neki novi izazov. Ja sam rekao klubu da je, ako hoćemo da osvojimo ovaj titulu, mi moramo da imamo igrače koji znaju kako se to osvaja.
Pa
first Final Four, it was in Athens. Whole story, you know, that everybody tried to put pressure to you. You must be in Final Four, you must win because you play at home court, blah, 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 okay. The more important thing it was to explain to my players that nothing is different because we will play in Athens. This must be help for us, not to feel any kind of pressure. And it was one of the best games, final game against this club ever, 2007. In 2009, it was probably, for me, one of the best, if it's not best, Final Four. We played in Berlin, and again, final game against CSKA. Incredible level of basketball, incredible. We won the game last seconds after that we lead in first half 20, because, of course, of quality that CSKA had at that moment.
Znaš, meni je košarka mi je i posao, i strast, i hobi, i sve, ali opet moraš da imaš i nešto okolo da bi uhvatio balans i ovaj, mada je ovo opasno, znaš, mislim, i da te izvede iz balansa, ali je velika stvar. To je taj slikar, Petar Romčić Uskov je veliki slikar, on je slikao kao navijače svoje prijatelje.
It is a pleasure to visit Duško Vujošević, the most successful coach in history of Partizan. He will tell us now how he sees reason for success of Serbian basketball, as well a few words about the Final Four tournament in Paris 2010, when Partizan, with his on the bench, lost both matches in overtime.
To nije bila ekipa koja je objektivno bila za Final Four. Čak i sa među osam. Međutim, uvek kad više želiš od protivnika i napravila se neka dobra hemija. Mogu da kažem da nismo imali sreće na Final Four, jer iako smo bili neko koje je trebao bude presjećan što je uopšte tamo, praktično smo vodili pola koša protiv Olimpijakosa u polufinalu. Oni su imali taj zadnji napad. Mi smo pronašli stav zonsku odbranu da odbranimo taj jedan šut i mi smo taj šut Teodosija odbranili do te mere da je on promašio ceo obruč. Ali nije dobro, možda je baš i zonska odbrana koja je dobro odbranila taj zonski taj šut, ali nije dobro uradila podelu u zatvaranju u box-outu. Mi smo uprkos toga vrlo nesrećno izgubili priliku da napravimo taj do kraja veliki uspeh i da uđemo u finale sa Barcelonom.
For me they are champion. They lost two games but they're champion.
You know, young kid that he decided to come to Partizan. I was captain of Partizan, and we spent a lot of nights being together in the room. First year, like 18 years old, the key player in Partizan. Incredible for one player 18 years old to dominate so fast and to be in that level. He was a pivot, but thinking so fast like point guard. And he was playing more point guard than pivot.
Now, like Divac, was, let's say, pure diamond talent. Divas was a player which was possible to play all positions. Big game, big guy, seven-footer, creator, playmaker, whatever you want to do with them.
Everything, I believe, it was really different in 2011 in Final Four in Barcelona. He played really good. Diamantidis, it was MVP. Control everything that it was necessary to control. And I remember Nika Latis, it was a very important tournament for him because after that, you know, everybody started to consider him like a great player.
Ovo su sve mladi golubi, to je neka prva generacija mladi golubi i već imaju jaje.
Više ih imaš, a?
Pa imam dva para.
Dva para.
Ali se legu, onda mlade podeli. To se oni deli.
We are now at home of Dušan Ivković, one of most important coaches on history of Serbian basketball. He was three-time European champion with the Yugoslav national team, one-time world champion, and also with the clubs. He won two times EuroLeague with Olympiakos, and also he's a national coach which win most medals in history of Serbian basketball.
Eurobasket. In that case, in my situation, to speak about trophies is very difficult now. That I'm very happy man that I had so many players. Yes, it was so many, many, many trophies like European championships, maybe it's interesting that we won three times European championships. We don't lose no one game, if it is important now, but I don't think so.
He's my good father of my son and his wife of my daughter. Teach me a lot of things, not just like basketball coach, also in the life. And I'm very proud because I have one person like Dušan Ivković, like really good and very close friend.
Now, after 1997, when Olympiakos won all titles, it's something very interesting that I never was coached that again two times in the same team, same club. And again we won, let's say, that maybe the season was okay, we won, and the Greek champion, and we won the EuroLeague, 2012. And after that, all around me, let's say, it was moments of glories. When all these people is, let's say, with champagne, with cigar, with the cups, with everything, I feel very, very, very sad. Why? Well, very simple that I always cannot forget what happened just to come to the glory and to the title, everything it is after that behind. You know?
Generation by generation, we have someone in front of us that that we are focused to understand the way how they play, how they like basketball, and how they dedicate their time to basketball. Miloš, okay, people in the United States right now are surprised with him, how he passed the ball. For us that we know Miloš, you know, just to be proud that one more player from Serbia have this talent. And, you know, you watch Miloš and you understand that how much he likes basketball. And I said, like coach, it's very difficult that any player from my team or opponent team can surprise me during the game. One of these is for sure Miloš Teodosić.
Here we go, 40 minutes to a title. The tip-off is won by Fenerbahce.
We beat everybody. Final four and also over here in Turkish championship. Quarter to final, semi-final and final, you know, very, very, let's say, easy. Even if it's not possible to say easy, but we play really very, very good basketball. From playoff against Panathinaikos until the end in incredible level. Bogdan, it was, let's say, our key player, but Kalinic doing a lot of things. The level of his game in this game against Panathinaikos in Final Four, it was really very, very high.
Jumping for joy at the Sinander Dome in Istanbul.
This is a great place to be. I'm here with my wife and we're enjoying every day. I think the idea of people interacting with each other, great people and great food, A lot of people ask me, what's my favorite thing? People and the food. It's a very special place basketball-wise to play because the second that you step foot into this country, people know basketball and they want to talk about it.
History of basketball Red Star, it's very, very big. And Red Star, it's one of the, maybe, one of the biggest team in ex-Yugoslavia, maybe the biggest. The first basketball start on Mali Kalemegdan, this is the place where the offices of the club are now, and many basketball players are a product of the Red Star, and one of the best players maybe in the world.
We've had a lot of success at home, and a lot of that is due to our fans and due to the excitement in this arena. So we expect nothing less from our fans, and we're going to give them a good fight and a good show.
I played in other countries, and I never felt this kind of support like here.
The fans here are fantastic. From the street, they know the game, and they come and they watch to see a good match, and not only to watch you play and to watch you win, but to watch you play with a lot of passion, play hard, and they really respect that, and they respond to that very much on the court.
I think you will not find it in any other place in the whole wide world. So being here, experiencing it alive, it's just amazing. And you have to see it live. You just have to see it.
You know, all the noise, all the passion that there is, you know, that you don't see, you know, in any NBA match. The best fans, best passion is clearly in the Balkans and in Serbia, in those countries. It's clearly the best here.
I hope that this journey through Serbian basketball history has helped you discover some of the secrets to our success on the court. Now, a new adventure begins, one that will culminate on the Final Four in Belgrade. The city and whole country have been waiting a long time for this moment, and I'm sure the Final Four will be another great success in Serbian basketball history. Dobrodošli i srećno svima.
Sija juna, ciudad que merece ser organizador de Final Four es Belgrado.
And I'm sure that by looking this big love between people and basketball should be the best Final Four until now in history of Final Fours.
Serbia is a basketball country. So, believe me, it will be great.
Postoje samo dve zemlje na svetu ili u Evropi gde je košarka najpopularniji sport, to su Litvanija i Srbija, mislim. Mislim da ne postoji ni jedan grad danas u Evropi koji ima bolje uslove i standarde koji se traže za organizaciju jedne takve velike priredbe.
Okay, I don't know which country deserves more than Serbia to be Final Four over there, honestly.
Belgrade merit to have the final four of clubs. And organization and everything, interest of the people, is on very high level. We can expect really beautiful tournament.
It's the playoffs in the Turkish Airlines EuroLeague. This is the continent of Europe's premier basketball competition. We're underway here. Game one of this playoff series.
Gets the Brian Messier with the pound.
Anticipated and the pass over the top, an easy dunk. And
Žalgiris start with a road win in Piraeus.
Sergio Rodriguez has netted a new career high.
Three!